Me. Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and it's finally here. Dynamic subscriptions in Power BI for old school people like me, like mature people like me that's been using SSRS for a long time, creating paginated reports. We used to have these things called data-driven subscriptions, and now they're introduced, very similar concept in Fabric for paginated reports called dynamic subscriptions. What these dynamic subscriptions allow you to do is dynamically send reports as emails based on data in a separate data set or the same data set. And I'm going to show you how to set it up. Before you get started, you need to make sure you have build permissions on the data set that contains that information that you're going to use in your dynamic subscription, and also a paginated report that's published to a workspace that's backed by premium capacity, a fabric capacity, or a fabric trial. Okay, so enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. Okay, so I built my paginated report. It's got one parameter, and I want to send this out to my managers and filter it based on, you know, this parameter. And then I created a data set here, and this data set contains the email address I want to send it to, what the filter will be, and also the file type I want to send to each one of these people. And both of those are published. Once it's published, I head over to my report. This is just a paginated report that I'm running in Power BI. And you can see right here it says subscribe to report. So if you click subscribe, I don't have any subscriptions. I go ahead and choose create. You'll see there's two choices, the standard and the dynamic per recipient. You have to make the choice. Are you going to do the standard subscription, or are you going to use dynamic subscriptions? I want to be a little more dynamic with the way we send these emails out. So now I'm going to choose dynamic, and then you find your data set. Remember, you need to have build permissions on this data set. So I'm going to click next. Okay, let's set this up. So let's select the data. I want all three of these. If there were multiple tables here, you could choose all the tables. I'm going to choose this. You can see here, you can change the aggregation types. You can add some filters. It's completely up to you what you want to do. I'm just going to accept the defaults. I'm going to click next. This is the name of the subscription. You can enter the email addresses manually, but that's no fun. I'm going to choose get data from, and this is where I'm going to provide the email. Then my subject, let's just copy this. And then the message, your sales. Then down here, the attach full report, I'm going to switch this from a hard-coded value to a dynamic value. So that's the file type. Hopefully you're understanding. This is what makes it dynamic. It's dynamic based on that data set. It's dynamically going to go to these recipients. So if I have 10 people in that list, it's going to send out 10 emails based on those email addresses and those export types. It's pretty cool. So then I click next. If I have a parameter in a report, I can leave a hard-coded value, or I can get it from my data set. I click next, tell it how often I want this to run. I click next, and then save and close. And my subscription is created. What I can do is choose send now, click that button, and what's gonna happen is it's actually gonna fire off that subscription. And then if I go check the email boxes, you can see for me, it came as an Excel. Because for Patrick, I said, hey, the export type should be Excel. But if I go and take a look at John Doe's, you can see John doesn't get a lot of important emails, that it came as a PDF. You can dynamically control the attachment type, who you're sending the emails to. You can even control the parameters that's being passed to the report. It's pretty nice, and it's all based, you know, on data set. All right, what do you think? Are you excited like me about these dynamic subscriptions? I know a lot of people have been asking about it, and I'm happy to say that you can do it. If you want to know more about paginated reports, you should check out the playlist that's flying above my head. If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.